moved to West Texas 40 years ago. 40 years ago this year, and the war was over. We wanted to get out and make it on our own. And those were exciting days. We lived in a little shotgun house, one room for the three of us, worked in the oil business, and then started my own. And in time, we had six children.
I'll tell you, one of the most unusual things about my dad is that he's probably the most thoughtful person I know. And he's in a tough arena, politics. Yet he always finds time for the other person. He's famous for writing letters. This isn't phony, this is true George Bush. I can remember campaigning in Cooperstown, New York, and the night bellman walked up to me and said, I've got a memento that I treasure. And it was a letter from my dad saying thank you for getting his suit pressed at an unusual hour. And George Bush is that way.
You know, he can be very nice and friendly, but in a competitive setting, no one's going to out-hustle him or outwork him. He is just tenacious, extremely tenacious.
Once a year, we try all families to get together in Maine, and, you know, we feed off each other. There's something important in cousins being able to know their cousins, and having Gampy come out and drive the wedges in to build the tent, and, you know, every year, it's a tradition that's really special.
And the campaign has brought us so much closer together as a family because we are all out campaigning hard for him. And it's brought us closer together because we're sort of facing the adversities as a team. I was sitting home and I'd just watched this fiery interview with my dad, and I'll never forget it because I was on the edge of my seat and I couldn't believe it. And the phone rings and it's Dad, and he says, Darryl, I just had to call you. You know, is your car okay? I heard your car broke down. I'm like, Dad, you've just had this wild interview. But that's typical of my father because he doesn't think of himself. He thinks of other people. At times when you know, he has the most pressing things on his mind, and the whole country was watching this and crazy over it, and he thought of me.
I say it without boast or bravado. I've fought for my country, I've served, I've built, and I'll go from the hills to the hollows, from the cities to the suburbs, to the loneliest town on the quietest street, to take our message of hope and growth for every American, to every American. I will keep America moving forward, always forward. This is my mission, and I will complete it.
Fishing for bass or bluefish?
Bass.
Do you?
Bass, yeah.
More of them. You just don't think I know how to catch bluefish. Down.
People ask me a lot about the White House, and I really haven't thought about it much, but let me just tell you this. We've lived in 17 cities, and George has had a lot of jobs, and some of them have been very grand. We haven't changed. We're going to have family, children, grandchildren around. That's just the way the Bushes are, and it's going to be filled, I hope, with a lot of family love.
Has it been tough campaigning with all these grandchildren?
Well, we've missed seeing them.
Do you get to travel with them at all?
They're doing great. Oh, yeah, once in a while. We've traveled around the country with them, and makes it fun. Makes it fun.
A well-known Democrat said that if he sees you one more time with your granddaughter, he may vote for you. I think it'd be a good idea if you got her back in with you, don't you?
Well, we don't leave home without them. Come on, kids.
Come on, kids. Come on.
Come on. Jump in here.
Come on, Al.
Come on, Ellie. Oh, you had that cookie in your mouth.